This is Dr. TUHIN. I am going to demonstrate the experiment of adsorption of oxalic acid on charcoal surface. The aim of this experiment is to determine adsorption of oxalic acid on charcoal and to test the applicability of Pradhan's adsorption isotope to it. Before going to the experiment, let us see what is adsorption, what is adsorbate and adsorbent, and what is extent of adsorption. These are the molecules either in gaseous or liquid state. This can sit on the solid surface. This is the solid surface. Sitting process of these molecules on solid surface is known as adsorption. The molecules which are going to sit on the solid surface are known as adsorbent. In our experiment, oxalic acid molecules are the adsorbent. The place where these molecules are sitting is known as adsorbent. In our experiment, charcoal is the adsorbent. If x gram of adsorbate is adsorbed on n gram of adsorbate, then extent of adsorption is defined by the ratio x by m. Actually, the amount of adsorbate in gram unit adsorbed in 1 gram of adsorbate is the extent of adsorption. Adsorption is a very important phenomenon because of its practical applications. It has many applications such as in heterogeneous catalysis, removal of harmful gases from air, decolorations of solutions before recrystallizations, demineralizations of water, and many more. Now let us see what is Pradhan's adsorption isotope. Pradhan's adsorption isotope tells us empirically how the extent of adsorption varies with the concentrations of adsorbate at constant temperature. Mathematically, it is represented by x by m equal to k c to the power 1 by n. While x by m is the extent of adsorption, c is the concentration of adsorbate, and k and n are the empirical constants. If we take log of both sides of this equation, we get log x by m equal to log k plus 1 by n log c. This is a straight line equation like y equal to c plus mx, and we get the straight line here. If we plot log x by m and log c, and log k is the intercept, and 1 by n here is the slope. Now the apparatus required for these experiments are the 5 dry clean stopper bottles. These are the stopper bottles. All these are stopper bottles. And pipette and measuring cylinder, small feature tube, burette and conical flux. Chemical requirements for this experiment is sodium and oxalic acid standard, oxalic acid solutions, and standardized sodium hydroxide solutions, this one sodium hydroxide solutions, and phenolphthalein indicator, this one. And activated charcoal, already we have kept this activated charcoal here, and distilled water. So now we can see how to prepare the solutions. We will prepare 5 solutions of oxalic acid with different concentrations. We have already 5 stopper bottles. In bottle A, we will keep 30 ml of oxalic acid. Already we already kept here, and 70 ml of distilled water, and in bottle B we add 40 ml of oxalic acid and 60 ml of distilled water. Likewise, we prepare C, C, D and E solutions. After that, we can calculate the initial concentrations of this solution C0 by following this formula. This is initial concentration C0 equal to volume of oxalic acid into strength of oxalic acid by 100. Now what we do, we are adding some charcoal on these solutions. Already we have done that one here. After that, we are keeping this one on into the mechanical shaker. We have to check whether it is kept tightly or not. We can put here, we can set here the time and as well as the speed, and it will rotate and it will set for 30 minutes. After setting that one, we will keep that one for equilibrium reasons. And after that, we'll filter that one into the conical flux. First 10 to 20 ml filter will reject. It is necessary because some amount of oxalic acid or water will be absorbed in the filter liquid. After that, we'll collect 20 ml filtrate into another conical flux, and we'll add 2 drops of phenolphthalein indicator. Then solution is colorless. After that, we will go for the titrations against the standard sodium hydroxide solutions which are kept in the burette. The end point is detected when the pink color is and persist. This is already we have done. This color will come at the end point. The titration is repeated to get the component values. Now, we can, for all the solutions, we can get this component content value, and these are the values we can, for these values we can collect here for all the bottles, and this is, after that we can calculate the equilibrium concentration Ce by following this formula: volume of sodium hydroxide into strength of sodium hydroxide by volume of oxalic acid. And consequently, we can calculate the log Ce also. Now, we have to calculate the extent of adsorption, that is x, y, a. So, a we know already, this is a mass of the solid here, mass of the charcoal 2 grams, and the x can be calculated by this formula, that is x equal to C0 minus Ce into V into equivalent weight of oxalic acid by 1000. Where C0 is the initial concentration of the oxalic acid solutions, and C is the equilibrium concentration of the oxalic solutions. V is the total volume here 100, and equivalent weight of oxalic acid, that is the 63. So we can calculate x by m for all bottles, and consequently we can calculate the log x by m. Now we can plot, we can use that is this equilibrium concentrations and extent of adsorption are the fractions. That's why log Ce and log x by a will be the negative quantities. That's why, but it is easier to plot positive quantities. That's why you can multiply this log Ce, both log Ce and log x by a, by minus 1, and these will be positive quantities, and we can plot this one. Now let us see how this equation is modified. This is log x by a equal to log k plus 1 by n log c. So we multiply by minus 1. So this is minus log x by n equal to minus log k minus 1 by n log c. That can be rearranged like this way: minus log x by n equal to minus log k plus 1 by n minus log c. This will be minus log x by n will be used in the y axis, and this will be used in the x axis, and this will be the intercept, and 1 by n will be the slope. So these are the model graph. We can see these are the experimental points, circle indicating the experimental points. We can fit these points, experimental points, through the straight line, taking the maximum number of points, and we can extend that one, which will touch the y-axis. This will give us the intercept, and this is the slope. From the intercept here, intercept is minus log k, and slope is 1 by n. So we can calculate here the k and 1 by n from slope and intercept. Now it shows the straight line. What it indicates? It indicates that adsorption of oxalic acid on charcoal surface follow the Prandtl's adsorption isotherm. Next we get the we calculate and give the results. This one k and 1 by n, and that's it. Thank you very much.